We're also learning tonight at least four national security officials were so alarmed by the White House pressure campaign on Ukraine, they sounded the alarm before that infamous July 25th phone call, and then again just minutes after the call. But keep in mind here, the call was not the first red flag for them. The Washington Post reporting subordinates warned John Bolton, who immediately scrambled to get hold of that rough transcript of the call, but it was already being locked down on a highly classified server. The Post also reporting a source says Bolton, quote, went ballistic after a meeting in which Sondland seemed to be calling for Ukraine to re-up its investigations of Joe Biden. We've got a lot more to come on this in just a moment, but there's also the explosive development involving two of Rudy Giuliani's associates who were involved in his efforts to get Ukraine to dig up dirt on Joe Biden. The men, now under arrest, charged with conspiring to make illegal campaign donations and lying to federal election regulators. And listen, there's more. Here's where the plot really thickens. Those men, Igor Fruman and Lev Parnas, were picked up at Dulles on Wednesday night, just hours after the Wall Street Journal reports they had lunch with Rudy Giuliani at the Trump International Hotel in Washington. All three seen on video together in 2018. We've got that video for you. It's not clear where it was shot, but what we do know is they're congratulating the chief rabbi of Ukraine. Parnas is on the right, Fruman on the left. Take a look.
Just congratulated Rabbi Moshe as well. Hi, Moshe.
Moshe, how are you, baby?
How are you doing? Here with Rudy, congratulations on 120.
Picture. I love that picture. I can't wait to come back.
See you in Ukraine soon.
Yeah, and Anatevka is the best place in the world.
We love you.
Fantastic.
Well, Fruman and Parnas were actually booked on a flight to Frankfurt Wednesday night. Giuliani, when they were picked up, of course, Giuliani telling the Journal the men were ultimately headed to Vienna. Giuliani then went on to tell The Atlantic he himself was headed to Vienna, though he's since refused to comment. According to the president's personal attorney, though, even though he and his associates were all planning to be in Vienna at the same time, they wouldn't be meeting up. All of this obviously raising a lot of questions, questions House Democrats want answered. They've subpoenaed Fruman and Parnas, demanding they turn over the documents involving their communications with the White House, Ukraine, and Giuliani by next Wednesday. Sources telling CNN tonight that Giuliani's financial dealings with Fruman and Parnas are also under scrutiny by investigators who are overseeing the case against the two men. Giuliani, though, tells CNN he's not aware of that scrutiny and says he hasn't been interviewed by the FBI. And so what does the president have to say about all of this? Take a listen.
I don't know those gentlemen. Now, it's possible I have a picture with them because I have a picture with everybody. I have a picture with everybody here. But somebody said there may be a picture or something where at a fundraiser or somewhere. But I have pictures with everybody. I don't know. Maybe they were clients of Rudy. You'd have to ask Rudy. I just don't know. I haven't spoken to Rudy about it. I don't know. I will say this. From what I heard, I just heard about this. They said we have nothing to do with it. We have nothing to do with it.
And there is, in fact, a picture. You see it right there. This is the president with Lev Parnas. Caitlin Collins asked him about the news and about Giuliani.
Are you concerned that Giuliani could be indicted in all of this?
Well, I hope not.
Joining me now, Shimon Prokipes and Ellie Honing. So when we look at this, there are these two associates. I mean, the indictment is pretty clear and lays out exactly, you know, what prosecutors believe they did. There's video of Rudy Giuliani and two of the men. We're not sure exactly when the video was taken, but we do have video of them. What's fascinating to me is this reporting that they had lunch, the three of them, earlier this week at the Trump International Hotel, not too long before their arrest. And now we're hearing that some of Giuliani's dealings are being scrutinized.
Certainly the relationship between Rudy Giuliani and these two men has caught the eyes of investigators, and they want to know more about this relationship. Specifically, what we're told is that they're looking at the financial dealings. Mm-hmm. What kind of business interactions, transactions were these men involved in between Rudy Giuliani and these two guys? So now, what we're told, at least, the relationship is of importance to investigators, but it's the money. That's the big question. What was going on here? And who was funding these men? And who was funding Rudy Giuliani?
Because it's fascinating when we look at reading through the indictment, the money that was in there and where it was being sent and how they were trying to, again, according to prosecutors, Ellie, how they were trying to hide all of this. to, you know, blatantly skirt federal election laws.
Yeah, it looks to me like they're caught cold. I mean, reading through this indictment, this is a strong case, a strong indictment, even though reportedly Southern District had to speed up because these guys are about to get on a plane with one-way tickets.
Right.
A little bit telling there. But it looks like they have some sort of either wiretap or emails or text because there's direct verbatim quotes in here, which is powerful evidence, plus financial records, wire transfers, all that kind of thing.
And also what we learn in the indictment, too, is that a lot of this is connected to, right, trying to influence political candidates and things that are happening, right, politically, perhaps on behalf of at least one Ukrainian government official.
Ukrainian government official, but there's also a Russian citizen, a Russian national that's involved there. So this gets even more intriguing because, as we know, there was a big focus on Russian influence. Mm-hmm. And that is what caught my eye, certainly, when I saw this, that there was money coming from a Russian national to these Ukrainians. The other thing that you have to look at this is that you can almost argue that these men knew how to get to the president, right? They went to Giuliani, they said, we have this dirt, this information for you. And so they knew how to get to the president and perhaps try and influence the president. They couldn't speak to him directly. But what they were very good at is getting to Rudy Giuliani, getting to members of Congress. This indictment lays out how they were trying to influence a congressman to oust this Ukrainian ambassador. So these guys knew what they were doing. They were working with people. And who these people are and what was exactly going on here, that is the big part, I think, of this investigation.
Absolutely. We know House Democrats have already requested these documents. They want them by next week, Ellie. Yeah. When they're in the middle of a criminal case, how does that affect Congress getting those documents?
Yeah, it complicates it. I mean, these guys are going to take the Fifth, I think, in response to any congressional subpoena. They have the right to protect themselves against self-incrimination. But I think if I'm in the prosecutor's shoes here, I would try to coordinate with Congress, say to Congress, let us take the first shot at these guys, because the ideal, if you're a prosecutor, is to flip these guys. And they might flip. They're looking at real jail time here. I mean, real time behind bars. And if you can flip these guys, boy, that'll set the dominoes in motion, just the way Shimon laid out. I mean, Rudy's got to be very scared about that possibility, and who knows who else.
The president denying, obviously, he was asked about it earlier, saying he doesn't know them, sounds like Rudy's associates. Look, who knows? He may not know them. And let's be honest here, just because you have a picture with somebody, he does take pictures with a lot of people. That being said, it certainly doesn't create around him a very solid circle.
No, it doesn't. And we've seen every time someone gets in trouble that's close to the president, we'll see these denials.
Same response.
It's the same response. We've seen it with Michael Cohen. We're starting to even see it in some ways with Rudy Giuliani.
You think he's starting to pull back a
little bit? Yeah, 100%.
And that's why that video that we saw is such important evidence, because this happens as soon as, right, it's the distancing game. I hardly know this guy. You throw that video up, though, for a jury, and that's all they
need. Or when he says, well, I hope Rudy Giuliani doesn't get indicted. And as more information starts getting out, there is so much we still don't know that is part of this indictment. 100%, there are things that we don't know. There are intercepts. There's all kinds of work that the FBI has been doing on this. Mm-hmm. The fact that they weren't ready to bring this case,
and yet there's still so much in there.
There's still so much in there. They had to rush this indictment through because these men were getting on this plane. There's still a lot more here.